Welcome back to the course of Power Quality. I'm Dr. Prema, Associate Professor in Department of Electrical and Electronics Engineering, BMS College, Bangalore. So in the last class, we have seen an introduction to harmonics, and we saw the basic definition of harmonics and what are the common effects of harmonics in various power system components. And today we are going to see the topic of harmonic distortion, and we will also see the difference between voltage and current harmonics. We will see the difference between the transients and harmonics. We will also see some of the basic definitions of harmonics in power system. That is, we will see what is the effect of harmonics in the basic sinusoidal components of power in the presence of harmonics. So this is what we are going to see in the second lecture of electrical power quality with the course code 18EE825. So let us start the session with the topic of harmonic distortion. So we have seen a glimpse of harmonics in the last lecture, where we saw that the definition of harmonic is the distortion of any sinusoidal electrical quantity. So harmonic distortion, we know that it is caused by nonlinear devices in the power system. So what are nonlinear devices? They are one where the current is not proportional to the applied voltage. So such loads are called nonlinear loads. And in the last lecture, we have also seen some examples of nonlinear loads, such as any load which contains a power electronic converter. So the examples are adjustable speed drives, the motor drives, and then we also have fluorescent lighting, fluorescent lamps. We also have induction furnaces and arc furnaces. All these are examples of nonlinear loads. So in nonlinear loads, the current is not proportional to the applied voltage. The applied voltage may be perfectly sinusoidal. Just the voltage waveform, what is produced in our power plants. They are sinusoidal in nature. So we are applying a perfect sinusoidal voltage to the system, to the load. But the resulting current will not be a sinusoidal wave. It may be distorted. So we have seen the basics of electrical engineering, that if you are applying a sinusoidal voltage to a resistive load, the voltage and current are in phase. If you are applying it to an inductive load, the current lags the voltage. And if you apply sinusoidal voltage to capacitive load, the current leads the voltage. So this is because these loads are linear. You can have the resistance, inductance, or capacitance are linear loads. Because the current is proportional to the voltage in it, we can say that the loads are linear and the resulting current waveform is sinusoidal. Either they will be lagging or leading or in phase, but the current will be sinusoidal in nature. Whereas if you are applying to a nonlinear load, the current is not going to be sinusoidal and they'll be distorted. And the problem is that if you are increasing the applied voltage for a very few percent, maybe 1% or 2% also, it may cause the current to double and take a completely different waveform. So let us take an example of how it is going to be. So in this figure, we have a circuit where we are applying a perfectly sine wave. So V of t is the sine wave what we are applying to this circuit, and we can see that the symbol is given as a nonlinear resistor. So you have a nonlinear resistor here where the voltage and current relationship is given. You can see that voltage is and the current is not proportional to voltage. It is exponentially increasing, right, in the waveform. So when we are applying a perfect sine wave voltage V of t to a nonlinear resistor, look at the current waveform what we obtain. It is no longer a sine wave. You have a non-sinusoidal or a distorted current caused by the nonlinear resistance. So while the applied voltage is perfectly sinusoidal, the resulting current is distorted. That's the word. Increasing the voltage suppose if you are increasing the voltage to a slightly maybe 1% or 2%, then the current will increase, maybe the current may double, and the current will no more have this wave shape. It will have a completely different wave shape. You cannot say what type of wave it is and how much the current is increasing. Okay, so that is a problem with harmonic distortion in power system. So this is this waveform we have seen in the first lecture also. This is showing a distorted waveform. You can see that the waveform is distorted, but even though it is distorted, there is a pattern in it, right? This input waveform is having a pattern, and also you can see that the input waveform is symmetrical with respect to x-axis. When I'm saying that it is symmetrical with respect to x-axis, that means that your positive half cycle and negative half cycle along the x-axis are same, similar. So in such waveforms, so non-sinusoidal periodic waveforms can be represented in a Fourier series, right? So this is the Fourier series. When we represent this input waveform into Fourier series, what we have is several sine waves. So here it is written 60 hertz, because in US we have 60 hertz and India it is 50 hertz. And there is a term which is defined here, which is H. Can you see that H is equal to 1 is for 60 hertz? That is, H is known as the harmonic index in it. So if your H is 1, that means it is a fundamental component. And if H is 3, it is 180 hertz, or it is a third harmonic component. And when we say H is 5, it is a fifth harmonic. For H7, it is seventh harmonic. And if H is 13, we have 13th harmonic component. So when we are decomposing this into several sine waves, this is what we get. And why am I showing only the odd components in it? Because in the input wave, we have the waveform which is symmetric with respect to x-axis. And in such waveforms, we will have only the odd harmonic in it. So here we have positive and negative half cycles of the waveform of identical shape, or they are symmetrical. So we have only the odd harmonics. Let's say we are showing the odd harmonic. So you can see the amplitude also, the fundamental sign, the amplitude is reducing, right? See, when you come to 13th harmonic or 11th harmonic, you can see that the harmonic components are very less. So it is a general practice that you can reduce the, or you can totally eliminate the higher frequency components. So this is how we can represent in Fourier series. And see, in general practice, or as a general case in any power system, we can see that even though the harmonic or the waveform voltage or current waveform is distorted, it may be symmetrical with respect to x-axis, or it will have only the odd harmonics in it. In fact, the presence, if you have an even harmonics in it, when you see the frequency analysis of it, and if you find that there is an even harmonic present in the waveform, it is a clue that there is something wrong in the system. What could be wrong? Either the load equipment or the measuring transducer may be faulty. That is why you have an even harmonic. Or if you have a half-wave rectifier in the circuit, see, in half-wave rectifier, you know how the output is going to be. You will have only the positive half cycle. You don't have the negative half cycle in it, and it is not, the positive and negative parts are not symmetrical, right? So in if you have a half-wave rectifier, or in the case of an arc furnace also, the arc is very random, and in such cases you will not have symmetric. In such cases you may have even harmonic present in it, but as a general case you will have only odd harmonics present in it. So now on, for any analysis, we'll be taking only the odd harmonics. This is very important to be noted. Okay. Now what I was about to say is, as you can see that as your harmonic index, which is X, H, right? H is 1 is fundamental, 3 is third, 5th, seventh, etc. So H denotes the number of the harmonic component, or it is also called the harmonic index in it. So as your H value increases, you can see that the amplitude is reducing. So what does that mean? That means that usually you can eliminate the higher harmonic components in the system. Usually the higher harmonics, or generally it is about 25th. If you go up to 25th harmonic or 50th harmonic, the amplitude will be highly negligible, and that is not going to affect the analysis of the power system. So in such cases, you can totally eliminate the higher order harmonics in the system. So that is a general practice in it. They generally don't damage the power system, so we can eliminate. So now let us take another point. That generally in any power system, we depict the components in the power system in series as and shunt devices, right? And generally all the power system components, that is the impedance of the circuit, and we consider as a series component, and we will have the loads as the shunt component in any power system. So here, majority of the non-linearities in the system are found in the shunt elements, not in the series element. What are the generally the series elements in the power system? They are the series impedances of the transmission line or the power delivery system. We call it as a short circuit impedance between the source and the load, right? So that is the, we generally take it as an RL equivalent values of the transmission line or the power delivery system, we say. And that is a series element that is remarkably linear in nature. But all the non-linearities, or majority of the non-linearities, come in the shunt elements or in the load. So we have many times we have seen that non-linearities are present in power converters, and which generally comes in the loads, right? So to an extent, the transformers, all in transformers also, the shunt will have the source harmonics in it. So what is a shunt element in the transformer? It's a magnetizing reactance, right? So the magnetizing reactance will be in the transformers. If you have a harmonics in it, the main cause will be the magnetizing reactance of the transformer, which is also in shunt. So we can say that most of the harmonic sources are the shunt elements in the power system, whether it is a load or it is a shunt magnetizing reactance of the transformer. It is a shunt element which is causing the non-linearity in the power system. So we can conclude a statement that the main source of harmonic distortion is ultimately in the end user loads. So most of the harmonics in the system are produced by the end user loads. So this is about the harmonic distortion. Now we will see. So in this discussion, many times I have told voltage, there is a distortion in the voltage, there's a distortion in the current, right? So there is a confusion. What exactly will be the distortion in the voltage? What exactly will be the distortion in the current? So our next topic is, what is voltage harmonic and what is current harmonic? So there is a distinct difference between voltage distortion and current distortion. The word harmonic is often used by itself without any clarification. So if you are taking an example, it is very common to hear that an adjustable speed drive or ASD or an induction furnace is not operating properly because of harmonics. So any common person also say, oh, it's not working properly because of harmonics. What does that mean? Generally, there can be three reasons for if one person say that one particular device is not working due to harmonics. So generally there can be three reasons for that. One is the harmonic voltages are too great, or you can say that the voltage is too much distorted for the control to properly determine the firing angles of the speed drives. So what is adjustable speed drive? They are basically the devices which are used to control the speed of a motor, right? So whether it is a DC motor or AC motor, you would have studied in drives, in the course, electric drives in detail. What is an adjustable speed drive? So basically in adjustable speed drive, it is a power electronic converter which is used to control the speed of the motor. So if it is a DC to DC or DC drive, you may have a DC to DC converters in it, whether it is a buck converter or boost converter, step up or step up or step down, or you would have studied three to different quadrant choppers, right? So they are all used in DC drives. In the case of AC drives, we will have VBF control, or we have field oriented control. All these are different techniques for speed control in AC motors. And basically adjustable speed drives will have any of these power electronic converters in it to control the speed of the motor. So there can be three reasons which can happen when you say that you have harmonics in these devices. Either the harmonic, there will be too much of distortion in the voltage harmonic, due to which it is very difficult for the controller to determine the firing angle. So that could be one reason. And another reason can be the harmonic currents are too great, or there is too much of distortion in the current waveform for the capacity of some devices in the power supply system, such as a transformer, or and the machine must be operated at a lower rating than the actual rating of the machine. So that is that could be another reason. So you say if your rating of the motor is underrated, or you are using it for a lower rating than the actual rating of the device, then we say that there is too much of current distortion in it. That's why we are not able to use the motor to the full capacity. That could be one reason. And the third reason could be the harmonic voltage or the voltage has too much of distortion because of the harmonic current produced by the device are too much for the given system condition. So either there will be the distortion in voltage, or there will be a distortion in current, or there will be a voltage distortion due to the current distortion. So these can be the three reasons. Okay. So what I mean to say is that there are separate reasons and separate effects for voltages and currents in the circuit. So what are these voltage and current distortions? What I mean to say is that you cannot just say that there is harmonic. You should be very clear whether what type of harmonic or what type of distortion you have in the system, whether it is a voltage distortion or a current distortion. That the term harmonics by itself is inadequate to definitely describe a problem. You cannot simply say there is a harmonic in the system. It should be very clear whether it is a current harmonic or a voltage harmonic. Suppose if you are taking a system which is shown in this figure, what we have is a power system represented by the supply, which is a pure sine wave, and then you have the power delivery system, which is having a linear load or an RL, RL, LNC. And then it is given to a non-linear load. So in the shunned element, what is shown is a power electronic converter, which is nothing but a non-linear element. So this figure shows the how the current is flowing through the system impedance, resulting in voltage distortion and current distortion. So here you can see that the voltage, it is written here that there is a distortion in the voltage. So where is the distorted voltage? Here at this load side. So the voltage distortion here is a result of distorted current. See what happens, the current which is produced from the supply voltage is a pure sine wave, and then you have a transmission system which is linear in nature, but at the load side you have a non-linear circuit, right? So when the current is flowing, the current is flowing from the supply through the transmission line, and current is flowing through the load. Because you have a nonlinear load, there is a distorted load current, right? So here actual voltage distortion. So because of this distorted current, you may have a distortion in the voltage at the load side. So that is what I mean to say. So the voltage distortion here is a result of distorted current passing through the linear series impedance and a nonlinear load. So the harmonic current is passing through the impedance of the system, which is causing a voltage drop for each harmonic. So you see here, you may have a you have a current distortion and the voltage distortion, right? So here a voltage distortion clearly means that you have several frequency components in the waveform, right? Voltage waveform. So when you are passing this current, distorted current through the linear devices also, there will be a voltage drop. So here I have written voltage drop, and this voltage drop will have all the harmonic voltage drops coming in it, right? So the harmonic current passing through the impedance will cause a voltage drop for each harmonic in the voltage waveform, right? This will result in voltage harmonic appearing in the load bus also. How much will be the amount of voltage distortion? The amount of voltage distortion will depend upon the impedance and the current through it. So it is totally depend. The distortion in the voltage is totally depending upon the harmonic currents as well as the impedance in the circuit. Okay. So let us have a magnification for this. So here you have a current distortion, and because of the current distortion, you have a distorted voltage. What's the reason for the distorted voltage? Because when the distorted current is passing through the linear elements also, there will be a voltage drop of every harmonic component in it. Because of that, there will be distortion in the voltage also, and the distorted voltage is coming across in the load side. And the amount of the voltage distortion completely depend upon the impedance of the circuit and the current through it. If you assume that the distortion in the load bus is staying within, if you assume that the distortion in the load bus is staying within a certain limit, there are standards for the limitation of the distortion in the load bus. If you are maintaining it within a limit, say if it is less than 5%, the amount of harmonic current produced by the load will generally be a constant. And so we can say that the voltage distortion, the amount of voltage distortion basically depends upon the impedance and the current passing through it. And the load in the system will, even though the distortion of the voltage is produced by the load will know, will have no control over the voltage distortion. What does that mean? Obviously, the distortion is caused by the load, but the load will not have any control over how much voltage distortion it has. Suppose if you are putting the same load to two different locations of the power system, it can result in completely two different shapes of voltage. So you cannot say it totally depends upon the system impedance also. Suppose the same load is put in two different places, you may have two different distortions coming. So which is very strange, but that is the actual case. So that is what I say, that the load will have no control over the voltage distortion. So by the end of this unit, I'm going to take you through some case studies. There we'll be discussing what happens. Same load, if you're putting in two different places, it acts completely differently. Okay. So that's why we have to be very careful when you're analyzing the harmonics or the distortion in any situation. So here, there are some recommended practices which are defined by IEEE. So the first one is the control over the amount of harmonic current injected into the system takes place at the end use application. So the amount of harmonic injection takes place at the end use. And if you assuming that the harmonic current injection is within certain reasonable limits, say 5%, the control over the voltage distortion is exercised by the entity having control over the system impedance, which is often the utility. So it depends on the impedance of the voltage distortion. The amount of voltage distortion depends on the impedance of the circuit as well as the current through the circuit. So even though the load is causing the voltage distortion, the load will have no control over the voltage distortion. It depends upon the load impedance and the current through it. So you should understand that if you are concluding this entire topic, you should understand that there are distinct difference between the causes and effects of harmonic voltages and current. So when you simply say harmonic, you don't say whether, if you don't say whether it is actually the voltage harmonic or the current harmonic, there is always a confusion. So you should understand that there are distinct causes and effects for harmonics of voltages and currents. The use of the term harmonic should be qualified accordingly. By popular convention in the power industry, when the term is used by itself to refer to load apparatus, then we say that it is a current harmonic. So when you are speaking about the load, generally it is a current harmonic. And when you are referring to a utility system, the voltages are generally the subject. So it is a voltage harmonic. So generally that is how it is. So to be safe, it is always better to make a habit of asking for clarification, whether you mean the load side, whether you mean the current harmonic, or whether you are meaning the utility side or the voltage harmonic. So that is about the difference between voltage and current harmonic. So you should know how a current harmonic is produced and how a voltage harmonic is produced, and where is the voltage distortion and where is the current distortion. Generally, when we say current distortion, it will be with respect to the load side. And when we say voltage distortion, it will be in the utility side. Okay. So that is the difference between current and voltage distortions in the system. Now, let us see what is the difference between harmonic and transient. So you have already studied in the module 3, you are studying the term transient, right? So you would have studied what is meant by transient. So sometimes generally when we are talking about distortion, the harmonic distortion is always blamed for mini power quality disturbances that are actually transient. So we say there is a distortion and it is because of the harmonic. So not all the disturbances in the system are harmonics. So there is a distinct difference between harmonics and transient. Although the transient disturbance will contain many high frequency. If you see a transient behavior of a system, it may have high frequency components present in it, right? If you are when an event is observed in a power system, it may show that distorted waveform with some high frequency. So in transient also, you will have a distorted waveform with high frequency components. But the transient and harmonics are distinctly different phenomena and they have to be analyzed differently. So what is the actual difference between a harmonic and a transient? What is transient? It is a sudden disturbance in the system, right? Even though the transient waveforms also exhibit high frequency component, but they are mainly caused by sudden change in the system or an abrupt change in the system. And these frequencies are not necessarily be harmonics. They not generally be the integer multiple of the fundamental frequencies. So, but they may be very random in nature, and that these frequencies will not have any relationship between the to the system fundamental frequency. When you say harmonic, it has to have a relation. It should be integer multiple. They are called the harmonics in it. Or even though it is having a non-integer multiple, it has to be a multiple of the fundamental frequency. Only then we say that it is a harmonic. Whereas transient may have high frequencies in it, but they may not have any relation with the fundamental frequency. And they happen for a very brief interval of time. That is the most important thing to be noted, that a transient happens for a very short duration of time, whereas harmonics is in the system. So when you talk about harmonics by definition occur in steady state, whereas transient is a sudden or abrupt change in the system. And maybe the transients will usually dissipate within a few cycles, one or two cycles. The transients will, we will get over the transient period. But harmonics are not like that. Harmonics by definition will occur in the steady state. And the most important thing is that harmonics are integer multiples of fundamental frequency. The distortion in the waveform which produces the harmonic is present continuously or at least for several seconds. Only then we say, see, suppose if you have an arc furnace, you are taking loading an arc furnace, and then there will be a distortion in the system, which will be there for several seconds. Such cases are called harmonics, whereas in transient, it will dissipate in a few seconds, maybe one or two cycles, or maybe some 10 cycles, it gets dissipated. But harmonics are not like that. It generally happens in the steady state, and it will be there in the system continually, or it will be there in the system for at least several seconds. So that is the main difference between harmonics and transient. And also, the transients are associated with changes in the system, such as switching of a capacitor bank. Suddenly, when you are turning on a capacitor bank, that is a disturbance in the system, which is caused by the transient. It is not harmonic because it may get dissipated within few cycles. But harmonics are associated with continuing operation of a load. If you are continuously operating a drive, a variable speed drive, then your harmonics are present in the system throughout. So the basic difference between transients and harmonics is that harmonics are present in the system in the steady state, and they are continually there in the system. Whereas transient is a sudden change in the system, and it will be there. It may have high frequency components in it, but those high frequency components may not have any relationship with the system fundamental frequency, whereas harmonics are specifically integer multiples of fundamental frequency. So this is the basic difference between a transient and a harmonic. So when you are talking about a distortion in the system, you should clearly be knowing whether it is a transient or whether it is a harmonic. So I hope that point is clear to you, the difference between harmonics and transient. So what did we see in this lecture so far? We saw the definition of distortion in the system, how we can decompose the distortion or the harmonic into several frequency components of it. And we also saw why we have only odd harmonics, why we consider only odd harmonics in the system. We also saw what's the difference between voltage harmonics and current harmonics. And we also saw when a voltage harmonic occurs and when a current harmonics occurs. Okay. And we saw the difference between a transient and a harmonics in the system. Okay. So now we will see one more topic in this lecture, which is how we can measure the power system quantities under non-sinusoidal conditions. So when we are having a traditional power system, the quantities what we refer in the power system are the power. When we have the power, we have three types of power, right? We have active power, we have reactive power, and we have apparent power in the system. Also, we have power factor, and we have phase sequences. So these are the general system quantities we have in the power system. So what are the system quantities? We have power. We have three types of power. We have active power, reactive power, and apparent power in the system. We have power factor in the system, and we have phase sequences in the system. So all these, whatever we have studied so far, all these quantities are defined for a fundamental frequency context only. So we have defined all these only for pure sinusoidal condition only. But if you have a harmonic distortion present in the system, you know that it is no longer a pure sine wave. You will have a harmonic components in it. So there will be an effect of harmonics in all these components. There will be an effect of harmonics in the power itself, how the active power is going to be under harmonics, and how the reactive power is going to be under harmonics, and how the apparent power. Are they going to be the same, or they are going to be different? That we have to see. And power factor. When we define power factor, whether it is the same in the case of the sinusoidal and a harmonic. So that we have to see. And also, how is the phase sequence going to get affected in terms of harmonics? That we have to see. So we have to say that unfortunately, many simplifications in the power engineers we use for sinusoidal fundamental frequency analysis do not apply to harmonic. So that means there is an effective harmonics in all these terms. So we will see, we may not be able to complete this. We will see what is reactive, real and apparent power. So what are these powers? Traditional power system quantities such as RMS power, which will have a reactive, active and apparent power in it. So here, what is apparent power? Which is the volt ampere. It is a product of the RMS voltage and the RMS current in the system, which is represented as S is equal to V RMS into I RMS. So what I'm telling here is the basic definition, okay, what we know already. So apparent power is the product of RMS voltage and RMS current. And the active power is the average rate of delivery of energy. So how much energy is actually delivered to the system? That is the active power, right? And what is reactive power? It is also called VAR. That is the volt ampere reactive component. So what is the reactive component? It is a portion of the apparent power that is out of phase or in quadrature with the active power. So when you're resolving the apparent power, we get two components. One is the active power and the other one is the reactive power. So the one which is in quadrature with the active power is called the reactive power. So active power is the actual average power delivered to the system. And the reactive power is the quantity which is out of phase with the system. Now the apparent power S, which is the volt ampere, it's a product of volt and ampere. It will be, this applies to both the sinusoidal and non-sinusoidal condition, S is V RMS into I. It's a product of the RMS voltage and the RMS current in the system. But when you are taking the RMS voltage and RMS current, that depends upon whether the system has only fundamental component or it has other components also in the system. So how do we define RMS voltage and RMS current in a condition of fundamental current and a harmonic current? See, the RMS current in sinusoidal conditions is only V by root 2, where V1 is the amplitude of the fundamental component and I1 is the amplitude of the fundamental component of current in it. So in case of sinusoidal waveforms, whether it is a sinusoidal voltage or current waveform, the RMS value is V by root 2 or Vm by root 2, we say, right? That Vm is the amplitude of the fundamental waveform. So in the case of sine wave, you will have only the fundamental waveform. You will not have any harmonic component. So your VRMS is V1 by root 2 and IRMS is I1 by root 2. But when you have non-sinusoidal condition, and when you have harmonics in it, for any harmonically distorted waveform, the RMS voltage is square root of VH by root 2 the whole square, summation of V1. So you can write it as 1 by root 2 square root of summation of V1 square, V2 square, V3 square, etc. up to VH. What is VH? Or it is IH. What are VH and IH? VH and IH are the amplitude of the waveform at that particular harmonic level. So if you suppose if it is 2, that means it is a second harmonic component, the amplitude of the second harmonic component of voltage. And if I say I2, it is the amplitude of the second harmonic component of current in it. In case of sinusoidal waveform, all these are 0. V2, V3, VH, etc. are 0 because sinusoidal component will have only the fundamental component in it. Whereas if you have a non-sinusoidal waveform, if you have a distorted waveform, you will have all these components coming into picture. If you remove the even harmonics in it, you will have V1 square plus V3 square plus VH square. So in the case of current, it will be 1 by root 2 square root of I1 square plus I3 square, I5 square, I7 square, all odd harmonics will be present in the system. So this is how we evaluate the RMS voltage and RMS current in the case of a non-sinusoidal voltage or current waveform in it. We are going to stop the class here, and in the next class we are going to see how we are going to evaluate the power components in the system, that is the RMS, how we are going to evaluate the apparent power, how we are going to evaluate the active power and reactive power in the system, and what is the effect of harmonics in these systems. Okay, and we will also see the power triangle, whether the power triangle is same in the case of harmonics or not. Also, and also we are going to see in the next class what are the main terminologies which are used to measure the harmonics. So we will stop for today. Thank you.